morning says, I woke up this morning, saw the bright sunshine. I didn't have no doubt. The Lord was going to work it out. Amen? Now, we don't want you to come and look at everybody right now so you can get it out of your system so that our focus will be on the Lord. Amen? He's the one that's worthy of all of the praise. Amen? This is a day that the Lord has made. We're going to rejoice and be glad in it. At this time, we're going to ask the Amazing Grace Original Free Will Baptist Church Choir to give us our opening selection.
We have come into this house to worship. We have come into this house to praise. We have come into this house to worship. We have come into this house to praise. Entering his gates with thanksgiving. Entering his courts with praise. Be thankful unto him and bless his holy name. We have come into this house to worship. We have come into this house to praise. We have come into this house to worship. We have come into this house to praise.
We believe that the Lord Jesus is the way, the truth, and the life. We believe that if we walk in the light, as He is in the light, we have fellowship one with another. We believe that if we confess our sins, He is faithful and just to forgive us our sins. We believe that the world passes away and the lust thereof, but he that doeth the will of God abideth forever. Amen. Holy, 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 Lord God Almighty, early in the morning our soul shall rise to thee. Holy, 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 merciful and mighty, God in three persons, blessed Trinity. Amen. You may be seated. At this time, the choir is going to give us another song of praise, followed by our Wednesday litany.
Never forsake me from a divine.
Amen. Amen. Go with me to 2 Kings 4. Before you're long, you hear the good word. I'm not sure you name when I say it. Stand on the word if you don't mind. Amen. 2 Kings 4, get it with 8 verse. And it fell on a day that Elijah passed through some, and was a great woman, and she constrained him to eat bread. And so it was that as often as he passed by, he turned in thither to eat bread. And she said unto her husband, "Behold now, I perceive that this is a holy man of God, which passes by us continually. Let us make him a little chamber, I pray thee, on the wall, and let's set for him there a bed and a table and a stool and a candlestick. And it shall be when he comes to us that he shall turn in thither. And it fell on the day that he come thither, and he turned into the chamber and lay there. And he said to Gehazi, to his servant, call the Shulamite. And when he had called her, she stood before him. And she said unto him, say now unto her, behold, thou hast been careful for us with all his care. What is it to be done for thee? Wouldst thou be spoken for to the king or to the captain of the host? And she answered, I dwell among my own people. And he said, What then is it to be done for her? And Gehazi answered, verily, she had no child, and her husband is old. And he said, when he had called her, she stood in the door. And he said, about this season, according to the time of life, thou shalt embrace a son. And she said, nay, my lord, thou man of God, do not lie unto thine handmaiden. And the woman conceived and bore a son at the season. And Elijah had said unto her, according to the time of life, and when the child has grown up in a few and fell on the day that he went out to his father to reap. And he said unto his father, my head, my head. And he said unto the lad, carry him to his mother. And when his mother had taken him and brought him to his mother, and set him on her knee till noon, and it died. And when she had went up and laid on the bed of the man of God and shut the door upon him and went out. Father, in the name of Jesus, Lord God, we come before you right now, God. Oh God, we come, God, that we might, oh God, ask a blessing right now in this house, God. God, we come that we might ask a blessing on your people, God. God, we come, God, that you might have your way in this place, God. God, we ask that you would touch us, Lord God. God, with this word, God. God, let them hear, God, what the Spirit had to say unto the church, God. Have your way.
Have your way, God.
Have your way right now, God. God, don't let this word fall on deaf ears, God. But God, let it open up their eyes, God, that they may see Jesus, God. Have your way. It's in Jesus' name. Let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable in thy sight, O Lord, my strength and my redeemer. Amen. One day Elijah was passing by. I also like to give thanks to my cousin, Josella Davis, amen, for putting me on a program, and her pastor for allowing me to be in his pulpit. Thank you, my cousin. Amen. We appreciate it. So one day, Elijah passing through Shunem, and a leading lady of the town talked him and stopped in for a meal. So many times, we as women folk, we like to entertain people, especially church folks. We'll bring them into our homes and we'll cook Sunday dinners. Well, they don't know how to do that much anymore. Because we take them out now, we go to the restaurants. Because my house, they don't need to look for no food, they need to look somewhere else for some food, but I would take them out to feed them. But nevertheless, we just don't do that like that anymore. But this time, this old lady, this great woman, this noble woman saw the man of God coming in. And she wanted to give him something to eat. And she would bless him every time he was come. And she begged every time he came by. Ain't it all right? They said that she was a good woman, a noble woman, a great woman. Now, I can add to that that she had a spirit, amen, of hospitality, amen. She had concern, she was concerned about the man or woman of God. Now, so she went out of her way to make sure that they was well taken care of. Amen. I can think about if we just had our annual conference, how some of us had to open the doors for people to come in and stay with us, and that was all right. I made sure that if they didn't have anywhere to stay, we had to make sure that they have somewhere to stay and give them food too, because sometimes you stay down your whole week, it gets expensive. And then we're coming from up north. But this woman, we come as preachers and as ministers, we come in that we might give you a word. Yes. Amen from God. Amen. We come in that you might see what God is trying to let you know what needs to be done. Now, yes. So many times pastors and preachers, we go out, we stay up all night long trying to work with the word. Now, sometimes we work so hard that sometimes we don't even go to sleep at night time. Uh-huh. And he can give us that word one time, he can give us that word two times, it'll be different every time. We can find some nuggets in that word that we never thought about before. And I'm here to tell you, beloved, it's a struggle sometimes to live holy. Come on, somebody. I say it's a struggle sometimes. And my image on sometimes to live holy. Because sometimes things get up in our way. Sometimes stuff get in our path. Sometimes we want to hit somebody. Sometimes we want to get all ugly up on somebody. Sometimes it's a struggle just to live holy. Don't look at me like you don't know what I'm talking about. Amen. You know how it is, this walking up and down. You know, I think about some ladies by the name of Job's wife. Amen. Amen. Leah, how she was treated. Amen. Because she was ugly. Nobody didn't want to marry her. Come on, y'all. He had to wait. He worked 7 years for another woman, but he got her. Amen. Can you imagine how she thought about that thing all night long? Amen. Marry me because he didn't have no other choice. Come on, somebody. He really didn't want me. Come on, somebody. And I think about the daughter of Jelophehad, how they didn't have a brother, amen, or a son to give the land to. They didn't want to give the land to no women. Come on, somebody. But no women stood up to Moses. We don't have any man in our family to give them what was due to us. And God told us that the daughters are right. Give them what they deserve. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. They said the woman had wounded. They've been wounded. They've been trusted. Look at the woman with the issue of blood. Yeah. Amen. How she went through all of what she went through. Amen. Before she was out, there was somebody that can help her. Yeah. Think about the struggle to be holy. Yes. Amen. Think about how you lay on your sick bed sometime. Amen. Cry. Wish there was some relief somewhere.
Yeah.
Amen. You cry to the Lord. Come on, y'all know what I'm talking about. Yeah. Amen. And sometimes the relief just don't come like it won't. Yeah. And that's a struggle sometimes to be holy. And he went into woman and he ate with her. Ate food with her. Amen. They had a good time for sure together when he would come by. But one day Elijah said, I got something that I want to tell you. I got a blessing for you. He said it through that guy, I can't pronounce his name sometimes. Ebenezer. He said, what does she need? What does she want? What is it that she have need of? And she asked her, what do you want? See, you've been so good, such you gave us a room. So what can I do for you? She said, I'm okay. In other words,
that's right.
I'm all right. Yeah. You don't have to do anything for me. Uh-huh. See, because I'm live amongst my family. Yeah. I'm in a town where my people are. Right. So I don't need anything, man of God, for you to help me with. He said, but I want to help you pay some bills. I want to take you to and pay your credit card off. I'll go to the president and talk for you. I'll go to the lieutenants and talk for you. He said, what is that you want me to do for you? She said, man of God, I don't need anything. My pastor's well taken care of. I mean, we all right here at Ebenezer. You know, sometimes we might go through some issues, but we'll get it right. So you don't have to do anything for us over here at Amazing Grace. You don't have to do anything for us. We okay.
Yeah,
we just want to help you out.
Yeah.
Ain't it all right?
Yeah.
Amen. That's what God is looking for. People that's able to stand on.
Yeah.
He said, God, trust in him. Yeah. Not man, but trust in him. But Elijah has something that he had to leave with this woman.
Yes.
He has something that he had to leave.
Yes.
And he couldn't leave with one. He said, I know I'm right place.
Yeah.
I know I'm in the right house. Why is she refusing the gift that I have for her?
Right.
She says, don't play with me, man. Oh, God. In other words, what she said, don't play with me. You know how God gave that man that you thought was going to stay with you? Y'all only want that woman that looks so fine and everything, but you got when you took everything off. Oh, come on, somebody. You know what I'm talking about. People that you know God promised you this thing, the ministry is doing well, but now look at it.
Yes.
The man, look at him. The woman, look at her.
Right.
Oh, you promised this stuff to me.
Mm-hmm.
You promised that I'm going to be all right. You promised that this gonna work out for my good.
Yeah.
But God is dying, God. It's dying, God. What am I gonna do with this thing, this dead thing? What can I do with it, God?
Yes.
And Ebenezer said, I got something for you, woman of God. I'm gonna leave you, I'm gonna be positive. By the next time this year, you're gonna put a little boy, baby, run around in here. She's gonna play with me, man. God, I don't want that. I don't want stuff like that. I can't mess with you. You can't mess with me now.
Right.
But he gave it to her, and she was blessed, and she had a child, a little boy, and he grew up. Don't you know that when you God gives something, it will grow? It will grow. It won't die out just like that. It will grow. Come on now. But you gotta tend to it. You gotta nurture it, Pastor. Y'all don't want to tend to me. Y'all want me to worship me. You gotta nurture it. Take care of it.
Yeah.
She did. She took care of that little boy. She loved that little boy. You know how I take children to church and they looking all cute and stuff. We just want people to look out and adore them and love them.
Yeah.
But one day, he went to the field with his father. He went to the field with his father. And he got sick.
Mm-hmm.
One day he was all right. The hour at breakfast, he was good.
Yeah.
No, he was at breakfast. He was eating and doing fine. Mm-hmm. But one morning, that same morning he runs to the field with his daddy. Dad, I want to work with you in the reapers. I want somebody to help you on this paraphrase. He went out there and he began to work with his father. About 12 o'clock, the boy grabbed and said to my head. Don't you know the devil will attack you in your head?
Yeah.
He going to mess with you and mess with you to mess with other people.
Yeah.
And you had me thinking all sorts of things that shouldn't be thinking. Somebody done that. You just thinking it in your head.
Right.
Okay, I'll come. Y'all know what I'm talking about.
Right. Right.
But he said, take him to his mom. He said, put him in his mama's lap. The servant took him to his mom and put him. You know, everybody gonna go to their mama when he's sick.
Amen.
Everybody gonna go to their mama. Mama know how to fix something.
Right.
Mama know how to get some things straightened out. Mama work it out. Y'all know what I'm talking about.
Yeah.
And he took him to his mother and mother. I'm sure she laid hands on him, put anointing oil on him. Fist him right up.
Yeah.
But he died. Mm. He died.
Yes.
I'm sure she was crying. But she had the spirit of power.
Yes.
Oh, she wasn't. Nobody didn't know that she was going through. Kind of like y'all today.
Alright.
Nobody knows you're going through.
Yes.
But you know you're going through.
Amen.
You know you got some issues.
Yeah.
This woman carried herself in a way that nobody didn't know what was going on with this woman. And so she took the dead child and she came to the room that she made for the prophet. And she laid him out on the bed. She didn't put him in the ground, y'all. She laid him out on the bed.
Yeah.
When somebody asked her what was going on, she said, it's well.
It's
well. She prophesied him. Oh, shit. Come on, somebody.
Yeah.
She prophesied, it's all right with you. And she followed. She went to her husband. Said, I need a horse or a donkey, whatever they were riding back in that time. Said, I need something to ride on. He said, what you need? But it ain't that time. He said, oh, don't ask me no question. I think she got a little tea with her husband. Don't ask me no question. Just go get him and fix him so I can ride. And I want the servant to go with me. And she told the servant to ride until I tell you to do differently. So I ride until I tell you to slow down. Since she didn't, I don't think she won't tell him to slow down. But she told that man to ride. He began to ride. And he would carry her to the prophet. Come on, somebody.
Yeah.
He would carry her to the prophet.
Yeah.
And the prophet saw him coming afar off. And Elijah told Jehazi, said, go and see what's wrong. And he began to run off. And he run and tells her what's wrong. Said, is everybody all right? Is it your son? Is it your husband? She said, it's well.
All right.
She said, it's well.
Yes.
And she didn't stop going until she got to the man of God. And when she told him, she grabbed him, held on to him. She said, I told you, I didn't want anything. But she said, my son, she told me. Gehazi, said, go. Take my staff and go to a lady on son. She took the staff, Gehazi,
I guess he must have run everybody.
But he got on him by the door, but she wasn't leaving him. Brother Kirk, can you come in for me? Okay. I need my actress. Come on, Brother Kirk. Come on. Well, let me knock him down. And she took him. And she went. This is Gehazi right here now. And Gehazi went on him and took the staff and laid it on the boy. And by the time he got back, the door, Elijah was there with the woman.
All
right. So he said, Elijah, nothing didn't happen to him. He's still dead. Don't you know, Pastor, that we can't push off our stuff to somebody else?
Amen.
Do you know that we can't get somebody else? What we are supposed to be doing,
amen,
we can't hand it off to somebody else.
Amen.
Yeah. We can't give God anything.
Amen.
Amen. I'm really sneezing again, I think. Come on. It's full, right, y'all?
They said it went on.
And it began to sneeze again. And it kept on sneezing, sneezing for me one more time. I think that's five. I think you need to do one more. Come on. Uh-oh. Come on, somebody. You see life begin to get in that young man. Come on, somebody. We got to understand that God would love to be a real person. Coming over your stuff. Be patient with your stuff. Understand what God is trying to do. You got to nourish your ministry. You got to nourish your marriage. You got to nourish your children. You got to do what God told you to do. Put that thing there to go wild there with your way. You got to pay attention to some things, God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. He gave us that. Amen. He wants to take care of. He wants to look at. Amen. Praise our God. And we got to understand what God is trying to do for us.
Amen.
He went and covered that boy with his body. And that boy began to speak. So many times we just forget about what God is doing. Sometimes we leave the church because we just don't understand. Why do I have to go through so much? Pastor, I just don't get it. I'm not going to stay here and just give my money to you for no reason. I need to see something. But I need to see a sign. Come on, somebody. Pay attention. Pay attention. When Elijah came in contact with his servant, it was severe grief of the mother. The Shulamite woman was hurt. She loved that boy with her whole heart. You know, she loved Elijah, and he was just a man passing through. Can you imagine how she loved that little boy? And now he's dead. Before she know he's dead. Have you ever felt something so new to you that you had to seemingly die with it? Sometimes people die with people that die. You know somebody, I know a preacher that died. And they love this woman so much in our body. Amen. One, the sister died not long after her. Amen. We need to understand that we're not careful. We'll die in our ministry.
Yeah.
Amen. We'll die in our marriages.
Mm-hmm.
Come on, somebody.
Amen.
We'll die in our relationship.
Yeah.
That's why God wants you to pay attention to what's going on around you. Understand what's happening in your life. But you need to pay attention. Come on, somebody. He said, then he said to Gehazi, girl, up thyself and go and do what I told you to do. He went and did exactly what he told me to do. But it takes pastors. It takes the leader of the church to make out something to make it right. Even the ministers, even the deacons, the deaconess. Amen. Reverends. Amen. Preachers. Amen. We are leaders of the church, even the mothers. We got to know that we got to stand right with God and be ready when he calls us to be ready. So many times we mess up though. We mess up so bad sometimes. But we know we gotta come back to God. He will fix it every time.
Yeah.
He will get us right.
Yes.
She is needed to extend into the fields of the farmer. She is needed to go wherever there is for her to go. This woman know exactly what she did. You know how you pray to God? You know how you turn over your plate and fast.
Amen.
You know how you give up things just so somebody else can have.
Yeah.
Come on, y'all. We put ourselves out there.
Yeah.
So this woman know why this child had to die. She had that problem in her heart. What's going on? I'm paraphrasing.
Mm-hmm. Amen.
But the man of God, she didn't realize her son was sleeping at this time.
All right.
She didn't know. See, we got to be like what Job said 4:22. The covering became a place of refuge.
Yes.
Of refreshing.
Amen.
Psalms 91:4 said covering became a place of protection. So when Elijah laid over that boy, he put everything on him that he could to cover that boy. It said that in Psalm 109:29, said the covering became a place of confusion for the enemy. The enemy sometimes can't even touch you, dog.
Mm-hmm.
He got that covering.
Right. Yes.
The covering got to be there.
Yes.
You got to have that cover on your pastor. The cover of the deacon, the cover of the mother, the cover of grace, the cover of mercy, the cover of God's goodness, the cover of healing, the cover of deliverance, the cover of power, and the cover of the blood. God held that covering all over our bodies, so we be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. How many times? Did it take you to get where you are?
Amen.
How long did it take you to get where you are? And sometimes we still bumping up against things. See, we still have a struggle to be holy. Sometimes. It's not all the time, but sometimes. To get to where God wants us to be. How long did it take you? Now it's more. Thank God, it's even more time. Oh. I believe it's it. I think it's 7 times 7. He sneezed 7 times. Amen. So now the boy is alive. And he called for the woman into to come get your son. And I'm sure that her heart filled up with a lot of love for the baby. I'm sure she felt so good down on the inside. Now, it said, then he returned and walked in the house and saw what was going on. Now, I'm sure she was so glad that she just didn't know what to do. It was not a wall falling like it did in Joshua. Come on, somebody. It was just a sneeze. Ain't that all right? Now, some simple little thing. It was not a river parting. Now, it was just a little sneeze. Come on, somebody. Now, it was not manna falling from heaven. Now, it was just a little sneeze. It was not that. It was just a little sneeze. It was not that. It was not that. But it was just a little sneeze. And praise our God. And that sneeze meant so much. It gave it life. Come on, somebody. It was a simple little sneeze. In fact, it was 7 of them. Come on, somebody. It was a very nothing more than a simple sneeze. And sometimes we don't have to be educated to sneeze.
All
right. What? Y'all hear me over here? I said you don't have to be educated to sneeze. You don't have to have a PhD to sneeze. Matter of fact, it ain't got nothing to do with you. It'll come up on by itself. Praise our God. It's not a pretty thing. Especially when my daughter sneezes. She scared me when she sneezes. It's so loud. It's not in the news. What? What you doing? Some people can sneeze just that loud.
Yes.
Amen. This woman, she came and got her son. That sneezed 7 times. Amen. He's alive now. And I'm sure she's feeling my good. And sometimes we got to put some stuff on what we're going through, y'all.
All right.
Sometimes we got to put some prayer on this.
Right.
Sometimes our ministry, God, we got to pray on it. Sometimes our marriage, we got to pray on it. Sometimes our long suffering, we got to put some prayer on it. Sometimes we're going through some things here and there, we got to put some stuff on it. Just like we don't know what we're going through, but we got to put some praise on it. We got to put some shout on it. We got to put some love on it. We got to put some love on it. We got to put some shout on it. We got to put some praise on it.
Come on now.
Somebody.
Come on.
Now, especially when you know your married woman.
that you listen to my text with
her. Amen.
Hear me. They ain't my text, never mind. I'm just sorry.
Give
my own way. We gotta stay on this thing. When the Lord, you see, my thing I'm talking about, the woman's talking a little bit too long. A little bit too long.
Yes, Lord.
Stay right there. Amen.
I'm still here.
Pray over your deliverance.
Thank God.
What God has given you.
Yeah.
Don't let your stuff die. Right. Don't let your marriage die. Don't be in church.
Yes.
Because you're in church, you shouldn't die.
Yes.
And then because you're in church,
yes,
your ministry shouldn't die.
Yes.
Because your relationship shouldn't die.
Amen.
I mean, that's kind of crazy to me anyway.
Yes.
But a lot of stuff happened right here in the church.
Yes.
Don't let stuff die. Praise the Lord, church.
Amen.
Amen. Pray over your stuff. Shout over your stuff.
Amen.